Hey, it's SGU, and welcome to MLB The Show 17 release day. And that means we've got plenty of content on the channel. We started with a 3.5 hour live stream last night, right when the game released. If you haven't seen that, go check it out. We did a lot of fun stuff, Road to the Show. We did retro mode. We checked out a little franchise, checked out the new SunTrust Park of the Atlanta Braves in our franchise. But now it's time to start up our brand new Road to the Show player for this year. We're going to port a lot of the oldies and goodies that you've come to grow accustomed to and follow their careers here. Joe Broadway, Matt Meyer, Billy Bravo, all those guys. But we're creating a new player because we want to go through all the first steps of the new RPG elements of Road to the Show. And so we are creating today a left fielder, throws right-handed, bats left-handed. I want to make him very all-around versatile here, so we're going to make all his stats very similar, very well-rounded here. We show the West region, but we actually made him from the Central region. So now to give this guy a name. You always ask me where my names come from. I don't know. I'm a big fan of alliteration, first and foremost. I want it to kind of roll off the tongue, and that is definitely the case this time around. He's a good old Texas boy. He sounds like a Colt to me. Colt Cannon. Just like how that sounds coming off the tip of the tongue. So Colt Cannon, we got new hairstyles to work with this year. I'm going to give him the Birdman. I'm going to make him kind of a blondie here. And just kind of work on his look. I almost always give my guys facial hair. I'm going to back off on the facial hair, at least for now. Can always add it later. Looking for kind of a goofy stance to go with. I don't know why, but Eddie Murray, that wide open kind of very unique stance right there. We're going to try it out. We'll see how it goes. And new this year, I believe, I don't remember these in before, custom home run celebrations. There's three pages of them from some of your favorite major leaguers. We're going to end up going with the Josh Donaldson. It's the one I like the most out of these to give him a little signature style. So there you go. Colt Cannon, our left fielder, 6'3", 215, Eddie Murray stance. You can go back and reference this video when you ask me, because on my players, he always asks me, what stance is he using? What batting stance? This and that. I tried to include some of that in the video so you can check it out. So now it is time for Bowman Scout Day, and let's hear from our narrator for the first time.
Though encouraged by many to approach Scout Day just like any other workout, these players know it is anything but that. The prospects warm up and stretch before the first test, which will be the 60-yard dash. While its purpose is to evaluate foot speed, it also gives amped-up young players a chance to outrun their nerves.
Okay, so clocking in on our dash times here. It's kind of nice to have the narrator. It's maybe a step down from having actual talk from our player, but we'll take it.
After an anxious wait, a player is called to put his plate skills on display. Scout Day coaches do what they can to ground and focus the player for a stock-defining moment.
Okay, so Bowman Scout Day is nothing new to the game. We had it last year, but just the way they're approaching it with the RPG elements of being able to answer some questions as you go, kind of show some of your arrogance or how you're a team player or how you're just kind of going with the flow. You can kind of decide how you're going to interact with people and what that is going to have as far as an effect on your career and some of the decisions you make and some of the decisions that the people around you make, your team GM, your scouts you're dealing with, your high school coach that you're dealing with, media, whatever we come across.
A fielding coach preps the player to showcase his defensive skills. This will be the last chance the player has to make an impression on this day.
So the batting portion went so-so. We didn't crank anything out of the park or anything like that, but we made solid contact. Now we take the field out in left and show our range as far as we can move to our left, to our right, make some catches, and then eventually throw to certain bases, third base, home plate. Right now we're still just tracking down fly balls. Now we're going to move to our right towards the left field line, make that catch. Now, throw to home. All right, one thing I realized right now is that the default is set to this showtime throwing mechanic, which I suck at, so I'm going to be changing that to the meter and the accuracy button setting. But for now, we go with it.
When it's over, some scouts come down to make personal contact with a player of interest. This is a marketplace, and though the day's action is over, product inspection and analysis continue.
So here's where you can start showing your personality. You're just going to be the yes sir guy, or you're going to be the boisterous one. We're going to play it pretty safe here. We're going to take the compliments, and we're not going to boast about ourselves. We're just going to try to let our play on the field do the talking. Now, we have the choice to just end with the Bowman Scout Day, be happy enough with what we've done and move on to the draft, or we can play in the prospect showcase, which could maybe jump our draft stock or drop it. Let's go talk about those options.
A promising young baseball talent receives a call from his former high school coach, who has assumed an advisory role until the player sees fit to take on a sports agent.
All right, so this is where our high school coach comes in. He's helping us out with some advice before we get an agent. Eventually, that's going to have to happen here. I would imagine. I don't think you can decline an agent. Well, maybe you can. I don't know. I guess we'll find out. Let's see how this conversation progresses.
In the aftermath of a scout day, players are anxious to learn what impact their performance may have made.
Colt obviously wants to know how his performance at the scout day will affect his draft status with the teams. Kind of talking this over here and getting some good advice.
Modern media offers an unprecedented glut of feedback opportunities.
We basically just asked his advice there on whether we should be paying attention to social media and what the media are saying in general, or if we should just kind of stay away from that. We'll see what Colt chooses here. Haters going to be haters, right? Yeah, let's go with that answer.
But wisdom would suggest a young athlete focus on what is ahead, what is in his control.
That's right. And what Colt can control is whether he is going to play in the showcase or not, further show off for the scouts, or if he's good with what he did. You know, I kind of feel like we need to show a little more. Let's sign up for at least one game in the showcase, because I believe they'll give you the option to opt out after one. We'll kind of see how this goes for us. So we're into the main menu for Road to the Show for the first time, which is the clubhouse. I love the feel of this. It just feels so much more like baseball. Instead of staring at a blank screen to see the guys hanging out in the clubhouse, it feels more career-oriented. I just like the move for it. It's simple, but it is effective. So here we go. It's game one of the Topps Amateur Showcase. Suiting up for the Central team here. Looks like they'll be hitting him in the ninth spot, so bottom of the order, and playing left field. Here he's got a chance to track a fly ball down early, and he does so easily, making the catch, and that signals the end of the inning. However, they are down 2-0 at this point. So how about his first at bat? Colt Cannon out of Texas, 6'3", 215. Let's see what he can do to impress the scouts with the bat. Runner on first, kind of a swing that was in on the hands right there. He is able to get down the line and make sure there is not a double play, but it's a fielder's choice. He'll be 0-1. All right, next at bat, and a runner in scoring position. He's going to hit that one to second base. He's now 0-2. No luck at the plate so far. Let's see if he can break through. First, he's got to go back out on the field. Nothing he can do about this. This is going to fall in front of him, and he's just going to have to play this back into the cutoff, man. Not earning any points or any real attention right there for what he's doing. Let's see if he gets another chance out here in left. Oh, he's going to have to get back to the wall. Can he get back there and maybe rob it? No. No chance. That's over the fence. 3-run homer. And the West flexing their muscles right now as they take that one out of the ballpark. And a big lead. Chance for a hit. He hit it well, but right at the shortstop. He's got nothing to show for his day at the plate so far. 0-3, and that's what you see right there with the line out in the seventh inning. But he's going to get another chance here in the late going, and trying to make a comeback is the Central team, and that is up the middle base hit. That's going to be his first hit of the showcase, and it is going to drive home a run. So not only does he get a hit, but an RBI, and the Central coming back, seeing if they can make a game of this late. Colt Cannon, the first hit here. Not of his professional career, because we're not there yet, but first hit in the showcase, first hit in this series, and it's a good start. So, he gets a chance. We get into extra innings. He hits that one well, but it's going to hang up there. Thought maybe he'd get an opposite field hit his second of the day. Instead, no. He's going to go 1-5. The Central team is going to get the victory, however, 10-9 in extra innings. So, well, at least he hung around, and he got a hit in an RBI. Could have been worse. Could have been an over. There's his stat line per at bat for his first performance in the showcase. Let's hear from the narrator again.
As the draft nears and teams begin to identify prospects they may target, a game of dreams also becomes a game of dollars.
The calls are starting to come in from scouts. Do we care about this? Do we just want to focus on playing ball here? What choice are we going to make? Do we save that talk until after the draft, or do we want to hear more? You know what? I'm curious. I want to hear more. We're going with, like what?
Information is currency. A team that gets a player to name a price may gain an early upper hand in negotiation.
So it sounds like it's in our best interest not to go telling them what we're looking for right now. Just say fair market value, and that will be good enough. Keep them guessing.
After all, why pay more if you can pay less?
I'm not even going to ask him about the school route because I know that in games past you could choose to go back to school, become presumably more seasoned and ready for Major League Baseball.
A ball player must keep the game in his heart, but his mind on the game, or he won't be a ball player long.
But the downside to the college route is obviously you become an older player when you start your career, and we don't want to cut years short from young Colt Cannon and his road to the show. So here we are back in the menu. We've said we'll play another game in the showcase, which we will hit in our next episode. You'll see showcase game number 2. See if he rebounds from that 1-for-5 day and has a better performance, ups his draft stock. And once that is all done, we will turn our attention to the Major League Baseball draft. And where will Colt Cannon get drafted? I want you guys to leave your best guess in the comment section below. Where is Colt Cannon going to go? What organization will draft him and bring him, hopefully, all the way up to the major leagues? Let me know in the comment section below where you think it's going to be, and we'll come back with the showcase game and the draft for Colt Cannon.